Hello, I'm Paul Keith Davis with White Dove Ministries, and coming to you again today from my office here in Orange Beach, Alabama. I am very happy with the way things have been going lately concerning the warfare that we've called on the oil crisis in the Gulf of Mexico. I've been very pleased with the response of our people that have become militant, that have been walking the beach with a message of the kingdom to change the atmosphere and to begin to turn back realms of darkness by becoming beacons of light. And so I'd like to talk to you just a little bit today about our hope and our desire to bring to you these video blogs, maybe like a word of the week or maybe a word every other week, where we share our heart with you, the perspective that we have on what God is saying to us today. And very frankly, there's a lot that he's saying. There is a very active realm of the Spirit right now that is prophetic, and it's calling us to a place of militancy, a place of taking action. The one thing we cannot be today is complacent or apathetic. There is a very active involvement. We're discovering that right now people are emerging with a destiny and a purpose for which they were born. Before the foundation of the world, the Lord released in us these seeds of destiny that are coming forth. And so we want to talk to you a little bit about that, particularly from our perspective here in the South. We recently finished one of our most effective SOS meetings we've had in a long time. I titled it A Call to Arms. I spent several days locked away with the Lord here in our condo, no media, fasted for 3 days, and I came out of that experience hearing the Lord say that we have a call to arms, a call to militancy, a call to active duty. And I heard the Lord say during this period of time that he said, "Son of man, what do you see?" And immediately I saw the perspective of Ezekiel 37, the Valley of Dry Bones. And it's as if the Spirit is asking us the same question today that he asked Ezekiel. What do you see? And right now some are seeing a valley of dry bones, but others are seeing an exceedingly great army. Immediately I was then taken to the scenario of Elisha and his servant Gehazi as they were surrounded by the Syrian army. And the servant came out of the house that morning, looked around, and saw that they were surrounded by this hostile army, and he became exceedingly fearful. Of course, Elisha comes out, as you know the story, and seemingly perfectly at peace. And Elisha makes this incredible statement. He says, "There are more for us than there are for them." And immediately, you know, Gehazi had an impartation of a revelatory anointing, and he saw the big picture. And the thing the Lord showed me was what Gehazi saw initially was not inaccurate, it was just incomplete. We must begin to see things from a heavenly perspective. The Bible says you must be born again to see the kingdom of God. That means if you are born again, you will see everything from a different perspective. Everything you view, the circumstances of today, the things that are taking place, will all be seen from an eternal point of view. Paul says in 2 Corinthians 4:18 that we look, a very present tense word, we look not at the things which are seen, but the things which are unseen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things that are unseen are eternal. We must begin to see everything we do from this day forward from an eternal point of view. And so that's what we shared in our SOS meeting. And frankly, we have gotten an amazing response from all over the world, from people ordering this message called A Call to Arms. And I feel like it has struck a nerve in the heart of people, because right now we need leadership. And if you'd like to get that message, you may go to our website. You can find it on the MP3 download. We have it on our video on demand, or you can order a CD or a DVD. But we've gotten dozens and dozens of responses all over the world from people that are saying this is what they're looking for, that they have had a call to arms, an anointing, if you will, that they have been receiving from the message to begin to become militant. I was very pleased that last Saturday, we took a group of people out on the beach, about 50 of us, and I had shared in my message that the Lord has very much taken us to Mark chapter 5, where the Lord himself, as he was traveling across the Sea of Galilee, was met by a hostile confrontation. The sea and the waves, you know, tried to keep him from the other side, and he speaks to the storm, and it becomes still. And the interesting thing about this scenario was that the moment the boat reached the shore, the moment he steps out of the boat and puts his first foot on the shore of that land, immediately there was a spiritual reaction. Immediately the whole realm of darkness began to shift. Why? Because light entered darkness. and the Son of the Kingdom, the Son of God, walked that shore. And when he did, he brought the dominion of the kingdom into that realm. And we know the story of the demoniac of Gadara that came out and said, "Have you come to torment me before our time?" The Spirit said. And of course, the answer was yes. And so that was what we released upon our people. We anointed them with a kingdom perspective that as they walk the shores of Orange Beach and Gulf Shores, Alabama, they bring light into realms of darkness. And it will shift the kingdom into shift the realm of the Spirit into a kingdom perspective and release faith and release light and release salt. We are the salt of the earth. And so we just would like to invite you to participate in that. I know not everyone can walk the shores of Alabama as we have, but I ask that you maybe join us in prayer over this issue. More than anything else, become active in your faith. Do not be complacent. Do not be apathetic at all. This is a time for us to step into the purpose for which we were born. The Bible said that darkness will cover the earth and deep darkness the people. But God's people would arise and shine, for our light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon us. I believe we're living in the days when that will become a living reality among a remnant of people that were called for this purpose. So, Lord, I just release that anointing into your people that are watching this webcasting. I pray that you would activate every seed of destiny, every calling, every purpose for which they were born, that these champions would come forth in this hour and begin to do the works of Christ. Grant it, Lord, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We also want to remind everyone, we've got our conference coming up in October, October 7, 8, and 9, called Stirring the Waters of Healing, taken from John chapter 5, when the Bible tells us that it was customary for an angel to come down and step into the waters and release a spirit of healing. It's interesting that when we named our conference Stirring the Waters of Healing, we had no idea that the waters themselves, right out from where I'm sitting now, would need healing. And so we have a dual mandate now, I believe, placed upon us for our conference to not only release a mantle of healing so that we can carry the gospel of healing to the nations, begin to heal the sick people, begin to heal even in the church those that are fighting for their lives, but also even bring a mantle, a spirit of healing to the waters that surround the Gulf of Mexico. I believe God's going to do something miraculous. And so we'd like to invite you to our conference. We've got James Levesque coming in, Jason Hooper, and we've also got a few extra guests coming in, surprise guests. I've called upon a few of my friends to come be a part of what we're doing because of the crisis of the area. And so we're going to have a few extra special guests that will speak into the region and release a word of encouragement. So we hope you can join us. Go to the website for information. Stirring the Waters of Healing, White Dove Ministries SOS Conference. So amen. God bless you.